As long as you're having fun, that's the key. The moment it becomes a grind, it's over. I don't ever wish I was somebody else. But all bubbles have a way of bursting or being deflated in the end. We enjoy change and freshness, and disco was only one area we delved into. I have a huge ego and a huge inferiority complex at the same time. Everybody is a teenage idol. Now there is a new group every week. It seems like everybody and anybody can get into the charts. The secret is to make sure your family comes before anything else, because no matter what you do, you've got to come home. I think they are grooming me as another Gary Cooper. I love making records. I love making music. I love writing songs. He was the average guy. Maurice, I think, reflected every man. It was great being together as a band, but much more difficult being brothers than it was being in a band. The only thing I miss on stage is the falsetto. I will always have my songs, and I don't think I will ever dry up. The Bee Gees no longer exist. I've worked with a lot of people who are more famous than myself, who are terribly insecure. But even now, when people see me in the street, they point upwards, to the sky. By going solo, I could lose a fortune, but money is not important. I don't want to live on past records. I have a little dictaphone, and if a sound takes my fancy, or if a lyric comes to me in the middle of the night, I'll just record it there and then. I just love the feeling a close family gives you, and I wouldn't change it for anything. I like blues, but it is music I am too ignorant to understand. I never really did any disco dancing. I would be content if I had nothing but a tape recorder. I could still write songs and record them. I'm Mr. Boring, not a party goer at all. I'm the eldest at 51, and if the Stones can drag themselves around once more, then there's a few more albums in us. I've never been into parties, premieres, or nightclubbing. It is commercial pop that the majority of people understand. A working man's daughter would not understand blues. It is not the money, but the self-respect and wanting to create good music. It's very questionable, and we will pursue every factor, every element, every second of the timeline, of the final hours of Maurice's life. We will pursue that relentlessly. That will be our quest from now on. Leaving Australia was the hardest thing I have ever done. Maurice was a silly man. Maurice liked being silly. Maurice would prance into a room, you know, and his presence was immediate. My music, certainly, has never embarrassed me. Our parents came home one day and heard us, and they thought it was the radio, but our grandfather told them it was us. Sure, I'm leaving the Bee Gees. I'm going into films. The only thing that exists to me is commercial pop music. We had to leave Australia to become international stars. We were very influenced by the Beatles, no question. When you are in your 20s and 30s, you just want to hit record and you don't really care how it happens. When you write a song, you have an idea of how it should be sung, but it doesn't work out that way if someone else records it. You are never really prepared for criticism. You can be tops in Australia and be unheard of everywhere else,